Okay, let's proceed to the next problem or example. All right, a tripod supports a load P of unknown magnitude. This is load P. Nasulatan ko na kanina. Find the maximum magnitude of P that can be supported if the force in any leg is limited to 8 kilonewtons. Assume that the legs are two force bodies, okay? So the system is in equilibrium. So we are going to apply the conditions or equations of equilibrium to solve for the value of P. Now the leg is limited, no? It can only carry up to 8 kilonewtons. So if we exceed 8 kilonewtons, then the leg of the tripod would fail. All right, so first, again, we need to convert. In these cases, we need to convert all forces into its equivalent Cartesian vector form, after which we identify the x, y, z components of each force and then apply the equations of equilibrium. So this would be our free body diagram. Okay, so we have P, FD directed towards this point, at this point, you know, compression siya, you know? So if this would be acting downwards, then the reaction of each leg of the tripod would be, it would push pa ganun. So that's why it's upwards pa ganun yung direction ng force. Alright, so first we need to identify the coordinates of each point here. So I have already written yung kanina. Itong coordinates ng A. So this is nandun siya mismo sa may z-axis. So wala siyang xy components or coordinates. This would be, but it has a z-coordinate of course. That is 2.4 meters. And then point B, by the way, this it, hindi ito yung y-axis. Hindi ito yung y, nandyan siya. Nagkaroon ng typo error or typo. So coordinates ng B natin is wala, ano ba to? X-axis wala kasi nasa y-axis siya mismo. Y-axis, x-coordinate wala, y-coordinate is we have 1.8 positive. Z-coordinate of wala din. Alright. Oh, yeah, meron ng ilaw. Thank God. Alright, next, point C here. Coordinates natin for point C. X coordinate, ito. It's 1.8, negative siya. Then, pag ganun, yung Y coordinate natin is negative still, negative 0.9. And then, yung ating Z coordinate is 0. Lastly, we have point D coordinate. So point D, x coordinate is 1.8, that is positive. Y coordinate, pagano'n, negative 0.9, and then z coordinate of course is 0. Okay, so we have these forces. So again, we need to express each force in their vector form, Cartesian form, Cartesian vector form. Right. Let's start with P, or P to the FB. So FB is equal to, we have FB times, wait lang. Yung ating ano, position vector, saan ba nag line of action ng point B? Ito, force B natin. So head minus tail. So importante yung direction ng force natin, ha? So point, force B is directed pa ganun. So ito yung head natin is our tail. So head minus tail, so 0 minus 0, so wala tayong y or x. So 0 i, and then 0 minus 1.8, so minus 1.8 J, 2.4 minus 0, so plus 2.4 K divided by yung distance ng 2 points natin. Okay. So that is FB. What would be FB? in Cartesian vector form. So minus, so wala na tong I natin ah. So it's minus 0.6 FBJ. So we have, this is 0.8. So plus 0.8 FBK. So this is FB in Cartesian vector form. Next, FC naman. So FC, position vector ng ating line of action of FC. So we have head minus tail ulit tayo. So we have 0 minus, I'm sorry. Ito yung coordinates ng point C. Coordinates to ng point A. So 0 minus 1.8, so that is positive 1.8i. 0 minus 0, 0 minus negative 0.9, so that is positive 0 plus. So plus 0.9j and 2.4 minus 0, that is 2.4, plus 2.4k. So we have over the distance. So we have FC is equal to 0.575 FCI plus 0.287 FCJ plus 0.766 FCK. Alright, so that's FC. Next, FD naman. Cartesian vector form. Again, head minus tail tap. So 0 minus 1.8 is negative 1.8i. 0 minus negative 0.9. So we have 0.9. So plus 0.9j. And then 2.4 minus 0. So plus 2.4k. Alright, okay. Next, so FD now in Cartesian vector form is, so we have minus 0.575 FD I, sorry, plus 0.287 FD J plus 0.766 FDK. Okay, so yun na. Tapos na. Ang na-express natin sa Cartesian vector form lahat ng forces. Ay, hindi ba pala? Meron pa pala yung P, ano? P is directed downwards. Nandun siya mismo sa may Z-axis. So, ibig sabihin, wala siyang X and Y components. So, obviously, downward yung direction niya. So, P, K. So, na siya, Z-axis siya. So, minus P, K, minus because it's downwards. Right? Then, apply the conditions of, or equations of equilibrium. Okay. Kailangan natin makita lahat. Alright. So, summation of forces along the x-axis is equal to 0. So, ano yung mga forces along x? So, we have FBX. So, we have negative, wala palang x component, ano? Yung FB. So, 0. Wala. Meron FC, meron. So, we have 0.575 FC. FD, meron din. Minus 0.575 FD. P, wala siyang X component. So, that is equal to 0. Which means that Pag nilipat natin yan, so this means that FC is equal to FD. No? So parehas lang sila ng value or magnitude. Okay. Next, summation of forces. Hindi pala kita yun ah. Sorry. Okay. Summation of forces along Y. Hindi pala kita sa video kanina. Alright. So, okay. So, lahat ng Y components. So, FB may Y component siya. So, minus 0.6 FB. May Y component din yung FC. Plus 0.287 FC. May Y component ba ang FD? Meron. So, plus 0.287 FD is equal to 0. Okay? So, this would be our first equation. Ano? And this would be our second equation. And then, summation of forces along Z is equal to 0. So, ano yung mga forces natin along Z? FB meron. So, we have 0.8 FB. FC meron ding Z component. So, plus 0.766 FC. FD meron ding Z component. So, plus 0.766 FD. And don't forget, yung P natin lies along the Z-axis. So, downwards. Minus P is equal to 0. Okay. So, ayan. So, ito yung mga equations natin. Okay. So, how do we solve now the value of P? Now, take note that each leg. So, yung leg natin, each leg can only carry up to 8 kilonewton. So, we have to do trial and error. Ano? Trial and error. Okay, let's just use itong simpleng yung first equation natin. If FC is equal to 8 kilonewtons, since yun yung maximum, that means FD is also, so if FC is 8 kilonewtons, FD is also 8 kilonewtons. Now, if FC is 8 kilonewtons and FD is also 8 kilonewtons, what is FB? Okay, so if FB, pag dun sa equation 2 natin, if we substitute yung value ng FC dito and FD dito, makukuha natin yung value ng FB, ano? Now, if we substitute this two values here and FB would be greater than 8 kilonewtons, then hindi pwede. Dapat FB na lang yung gawin natin, 8 kilonewtons, and solve for the values of FC and FD if FB is equal to 8 kilonewtons. No. If FB is lower than 8 kilonewtons, pag sinubstitute natin ito sa equation 2, that means we're good. No. So if we substitute these values to this equation 2, what would be FB? So FB would give would be 7.653 kilonewtons. So less than siya dito, less than 8 kilonewtons siya. Which means that, dapat maintindihan natin naman buti, if I make FB is less than FC and FD. Okay? FB is always less than FC and FD. Okay? Yan. Which means that if I set FB to 8, that means FC and FD would be greater than 8. Okay? For FB to be less than FC and FD. Again, I repeat, if FB is 8 kilonewtons, that would give us a value of FC and FD greater than 8, which is hindi pwede kasi nga limited lang yung carrying capacity ng bawat leg to 8 kilonewtons. Okay, so we have to set the values then of FC and FD to 8 kilonewtons, and then the resulting value of FB is 7.653 kilonewtons. With this, we can now solve for the maximum value of P, which the tripod can carry. So, isubstitute lang natin yung value ng FC dito, FD dito, FB dito. Okay. Then we can now have the value of P here. So P here is equal to 8.379 kilonewtons. So yan na yung solution natin. Okay, so do you have any questions? If you have questions, syempre, hindi ito live enough. So you have to post your questions in our group chat, or you may message me personally. Alright, so let's proceed to the next problem or next example. Next example, the light boom AB is attached to the vertical wall by a ball and socket point adjoint at A. Where's that joint? Ayun pala. Sorry. And supported by two cables B. Cables at B. Sorry. A force P, which is already in its Cartesian vector form, is applied at B. Ito. Compute the cable tensions and the reaction at A. Alright. So, ito yung system natin. So, the system again is in equilibrium. So, we have to apply the equations of equilibrium to solve this problem. Okay, again, we need to express each force into its equivalent Cartesian vector form. So, this would be our free body diagram. So, meron tayong tension dito. Cable daw itong support sa dito. So, tension yan. Itong dalawa, FBC and FBD. And this is P here. Yun yung applied force natin, which is already in Cartesian vector form. And reaction natin sa A, ito ay, ano to? Boom. So, ang boom, pwedeng tension, compression siya, no? It can resist tension or compression. But in this case, if you try to imagine the entire system, ito yung cable natin. Ito yung force natin pag ganun. So, na if you can imagine yung situation dito, this is in compression. Nakocompress tong boom natin. So, hinihila nito pag ganun. So, nakocompress siya ito. So, ang reaction dyan is ganun. Towards ito. Yung pag ganun. Alright? So, nakocompress siya. So again, we need to express its force in its Cartesian vector form. Identify x, y, z components of each force. Apply the equations of equilibrium. And then we will be able to solve for the reaction at A here later on. Right? Since the body or the system is in equilibrium. So let's start with... maybe we can start by identifying muna yung coordinates. Let's coordinate ng point A natin, x coordinate 2 meters, positive, y coordinate is wala, so 0, z coordinate downward siya, so minus 3, at point B, x coordinate natin ay, ano yung x coordinate sa my point B? Wala. Y-coordinate, positive 6. Z-coordinate, wala rin. C. Coordinates of point C. X-coordinate is 2. Y-coordinate is 0. Z-coordinate upwards 6 meters. Lastly, coordinates of D natin, that x coordinate is 0, y coordinate is negative, I'm sorry, x yun pala yung x, my goodness. At is negative 4. X coordinate ng D is negative 4. Ayan, yun pala yun. Wala siyang y coordinate. And then z coordinate is 2 meters. Okay, I think we're good. And so let's now convert each force here. Itong mga forces natin into their equivalent ano, Cartesian vector form. Okay, let's start with FBD na lang muna. So where shall we write it? Ito na lang. Para may space tayo mamaya sa baba. Yep. Okay. So FBD is equal to, I hope this is enough. Yung space natin. Position vector. Head minus tail. So FBD natin. So that is negative 4 minus... Negative 4 minus 0. It's negative 4 minus 0 is negative 4i. And then 0 minus 6. That is minus 0 minus. Minus 6j. Then 2 minus 0. So that is plus 2k. Distance natin. So we have FBD in Cartesian vector form is equal to FBD minus 0.535 FBDI minus 0.802 FBDJ. Okay. Plus, sorry, ito na ilay, isuwal ko na lang dito. 0.267 FBD. Okay, so this is our Cartesian vector form for FBD. Next, FBC naman. Ito na lang din. FBC is equal to FBC times the unit vector natin. That is, so FBC. So it is 2 minus 0. So it's 2i. 0 minus 6 minus 6j. 6 minus 0. So plus 6. 6 minus 0. So plus 6. K over distance, square root of over distance. So FBC in Cartesian vector form is 0.229 FBCI minus 0.688 FBC J plus 0.688 FBC K. So, ito yung Cartesian vector forms natin ng FBD. FBC, ano pa? Ay, yung RA. Yung RA natin, Cartesian vector form ng RA. So, RA lies or line of action natin is andito along boom AB. I will just add it here na lang. So RA is equal to, so head minus tail. So nasan yung head ng A? Ito, directed siya ganun. So ito yung tail, B is the tail of FBD and FBC. Ano? But in this case, head ngayon ng RA yung B, tail naman niya yung point A, right? So that's it. So we have 0 minus 2, so minus 2i. 6 minus 0 plus 6, sorry, that should be 6j. 0 minus negative 3 is plus 3k. The over distance. So we have minus 2 squared. Okay. So RA in Cartesian vector form is 0.286 RA I plus 0.857 RA J plus 0.429 RA K. Hindi na siya kita. Ayan. So, yung P natin, hindi naman, given na siya in terms of Cartesian vector form. So, no need to convert it. No, kasi yun na yung kanyang form. But in case P is still in the form of a force, no, kung hindi pa siya Cartesian vector form, you have to convert that to an equivalent Cartesian vector form. Okay? Force vector form. Yeah. So, P is equal to 18i minus 24k. Alright. So, okay na? Ready na tayong mag-apply ng equations of equilibrium. So, let's start with i-adjust muna ito. May space pa tayo. Ayan. So, summation of forces along x axis is equal to 0 sa lahat ng x components. X component ng FBC meron. So, we have 0.229 FBC. Okay. X component ng FBD meron din, so minus 0.535 FBD. X component ng RA, so minus 286 RA. X component ng P meron din, so we have 18, positive siya, so 18 is equal to 0. So this would be our first equation. Second equation, summation of forces along y is equal to 0. So y component ng FBC, so minus 0.688 FBC. X component, y component ng FBD, negative 0.802 FBD. X component or Y component of RA, meron din. So, plus 0.857 RA. Y component of P, wala. So, 0. Wala na. Equate na natin to sa 0. So, this is our second equation. Alright. Next, summation of forces along the Z axis. So, lahat ng Z components. So, Z component of FBC meron is 0.688 FBC. Z component of FBD meron din. So, plus 0.267 FBD. Z component of RA meron din. So, plus 0.429 RA. Next, Z component of P meron, so negative 24, so minus 24 is equal to 0. So this would be our third equation. Now we have three equations, three unknowns. You can use your calculator to solve these equations simultaneously. So we can have the values of FBC. FBD and RA. So FBC is 8.731 kilonewtons. FBD is 22.419 kilonewtons. And RA, yun ang hinahanap natin. Okay. RA is 27.989 kilonewtons. Okay. So, ito na yan. Hinahanap natin is the tensions in the cable, FBC, FBD, and then yung ating reaction sa A. Ayan. So, that's it. I think this will be our last example na lang for application of equations of equilibrium in 3 dimensions. Alright, so next chapter na tayo sa next na video. Okay, so that's it.